It's okay. Oh my gosh, I don't know what to do. Oh my gosh, there's so many. I'm so sorry. Jumping back, huh? Jumping back? You don't know what. My name is Dee Dee Croy. Every pet deserves a groom. I'm here to get the job done and give your pet that opportunity.
How did that happen? See it?
So the real story about this kitten is on my way home from work, a long work day, all of a sudden there was a few vehicles over the railroad track that came to a complete halt. I looked around wondering what the holdup was, and I saw right behind this black Suburban, this little bloop, bloop, bloop over the curb. I knew at that moment it was an animal. So I stopped, I looked around, I waited to see what they were doing. Most everyone pulled off. No one got out to pick up what it was or check on it or figure it out. It was just a limp body that found its way to the curb and flumped over the curb into the tall grass right before railroad tracks. So I decided there's many an opportunity and this was one of them. This animal needed me. I got out of my vehicle. Yes, I left my car right there. I went over, I got like a cloth bag to grab. I just didn't know what I was gonna be working with. I looked through the tall grass and there it was, this kitten. I grabbed the kitten, opened the passenger door, put the kitten in the floorboard, lay the kitten there, got in my car and headed home. Little did I know that I was gonna be taking a kitten home this late in the day on my way home from work. And if you know me, you know I work some really long hours. So once I decided how I was going to situate the kitten in my garage, boom, the kitten gets lodged into my tire by choice. So that is the clip we've shared with you. We couldn't get the clip at the railroad track. I wasn't in a position to be recording. I was in a position of saving. So that is why I saved him that day.
So we weren't planning to pick you up like that. Okay, come here, let's see. You wanna drink something? This is all I got some milk, see? See if you take this. I'm sorry I don't have a nipple here. There you go. Open your mouth. There you go. That's what it is, right? Let me see. Oh, I don't have a nipple or nothing. Good girl. I don't even know if you're a girl or not. That good? That good girl. That's all it was? You were hungry? Is that enough? Hmm? Yeah. Hey.
Can you believe Dee Dee brought this kitten home? Like, does it have any diseases or anything?
Hey, you feel better? Hmm? You feel better? Let me see. Let's see if we can see. We do need to probably wipe you up too, huh? Looks like a female. Is it a girl? Is she a little girl? Is she a little girl? I'm sorry I didn't know what to do at first. We got you out of there, okay? We got you out of there. Now let's see if you want to sleep, okay? And give you some rest, okay? Just wanted to help you, that's all. You feel better now? Okay. I know better now, okay? Now how to help you. You're hungry? You're hungry? Do you feel better now?
You're too young for this stuff, huh? What was I thinking? I didn't think you were that young. Okay, come in here. I'll let you have the blanket in there too, okay? You can get some rest now, okay? You have no idea. This is crazy. Who plans to get a kitten on the way home from work in the middle of the night? This is crazy. This keeps you up all night, doesn't it? The kitten was so scared, it was hissing at me. Here, you want some? Do this. Here.
She's like, what is that? She's better with the syringe.
I wasn't 100% on the kitten's age, so at first, we did hurry up and put some kibble in there because I hadn't had any idea when the last time the kitten ate. Yeah, I know. This kitten needed some supplemental milk and also maybe some soft food. Yes, I'm Asian, and yes, those are chopsticks. If it wasn't those chopsticks, it was my fingers. It was one or the other. I always have chopsticks laying around. Thank you. Oh, you want to see this?
It's kind of loud. I didn't think you liked it. It's kind of loud. Here. A little moto. A little moto. You're so cute. More? You're eating a lot today. That's good. That's real good, girl. More?
They're flying everywhere. I'm just concerned of an infestation because there's so many. More. No, that's fine.
Look, you can see them all falling off. It's working.
Okay. This needs to be closed up. Let me.
You can see them in the water. Look at that.
I'm so sorry, sweetie.
You gotta get her head because they're.
I do have to get the head. They're all over her, everywhere.
Damn, they're.
Put some on my hip. Put some on right here. Just not in the eyes, okay?
They might be in her eyes too.
They are. Right? Look! Oh my gosh! God. Oh my gosh! They have nowhere else to go, so they run like tip. The tip of the nose is usually what they do, right? Oh my gosh, David! Look!
Oh my.
Look, David! I'm so sorry. Give me a flea comb. Come on! Run faster! Get it out of her eye. I need water. Bottle water. Oh my gosh, there's hundreds of them. I'm so sorry. Pour it on her face. Hurry. Okay, that's enough.
Oh my goodness. I don't know that I can, am I doing this okay? Oh my gosh, I don't know what to do. Oh my gosh, there's so many, I'm so sorry. Jumping back, huh? Jumping back? You don't know what to do, huh?
Yeah, I did jump back. They were flying all over the place and I don't want any fleas on me, man. Like, that's gross.
You don't know what to do when there's a stray kitten or a abandoned kitten and they're out there and they're by themselves and they got hundreds of fleas. You don't know what to do, right? I know, it's cold.
Oops, that was a little too much. I'm not perfect.
Too many fleas, man. Just do it.
I need a border. Okay. I'm gonna wash your face here. Paper towel, please. Gosh, man, think. Think. Turn on hot water. Leak home. Leave it, leave it. Give me that. Oh yeah, we're getting a lot off. Oh yeah. Leak home.
Doesn't make sense. It doesn't make sense. Go with them. Go ahead.
This is so bad. This is so, so, so bad. Dawn was the best decision we could make. Nothing that I tried, and I did try it. I tried the Adam stuff. I tried the essential oil stuff. I tried all of it, and nothing was going to even tip the iceberg with all these fleas. So Dawn dish soap was the best alternative for this moment, for this young kitten. And it worked awesomely. But it doesn't look pretty. When a cat or a kitten is going through this much infestation and you've just got to do the best you can, it's so bad. You just want to help as much as you can, but these fleas are flying and jumping and squishing around everywhere, jumping on his eyeballs. Oh my, it was the worst. But Dawn is great only during one-time exposures because Dawn was used also at that time in the 90s when there was that huge oil leak in the ocean. Dawn dish soap, oh my gosh, it cleaned off so many birds. This is the perfect thing to use, but this is not the perfect thing to use every day on your dog. Immediately starts drying out the skin because it is doing its job, cutting through oil and grease and dirt and grime. But this is so bad.
Can I turn you this way? Let me check underneath real good, okay? Good girl. Good girl, I'm so sorry. Look at all those fleas. They're still on your face. Yes, they are.
Hey, the flea combs might have taken them off. Like,
did I say 500, right?
Yeah.
Did you feel, do you understand? 100. No, I said earlier, today and yesterday, I said about 500. And today I said at least 100, maybe 500.
Yeah, that's a lot more.
You got that. Mm-hmm. This is you now.
Okay. Look at all those, man.
Once I saw the leg trembling, I knew I needed to speed this process up. But there were still so many fleas running around.
You can kind of say at least we didn't see any of them jump off, you know? But that's not saying that none of them did.
The downfall is Dawn doesn't kill fleas forever. It's not your preventative. It kills the fleas right now.
They haven't done her body yet.
I'm hoping they all ran to her head. At the rate we're going. I don't know what the heck is going on back there. Or you just call it a day, and then we gotta do it again in a couple days to make sure what egg hatched, things like that happened. It's really, really dry now.
Check the inside of her ears, make sure they're in
going. I will in a second. Still working on her face.
I didn't know in this moment that later on this kitten would have so much love and attachment to me. I didn't know that that would come to pass. But at this moment, helping him defines his and I's relationship, and it becomes pretty amazing.
Oh my goodness, there's so many. She's holding on to me. She knows I'm helping her. So sad. All right, we're gonna end it there. We're gonna pick off a few more of these and then dry her up real good and let her rest.
I think I was in the room and I had set up the camera, but I had no idea this kitten was doing all that to my furniture in the lobby.
This is how you pet a cat. Doesn't try to bite me doing that way.
Doing that.
The kitten loves cheese.
Didi got the cat neutered and we found out she was a he.
Can you come out? Can you come out, buddy? Oh, it's okay. It's okay, you're okay.
Where's that, Saki, huh? Where's that?
Miss Barbara has been a client of mine for a very long time. I took care of her Molly, and I took care of her Miss Kitty. Molly passed away, and it wasn't very much longer after that that Miss Kitty also passed away. Months passed by, and in my mind, I wish I could do something to help the pain of all the loss of pets in her family. Gosh, you know, you lose your family dog, and then you lose your very, very old 20-something, 30-something-year-old kitty. It's just a bad day, isn't it? This new kitten came into my life. I kept thinking about Barbara, and I felt like everything I was going to do was going to prepare this kitten to possibly give to her. And here we are. The kitten's going into her home.
All right, let's go.
You got your new home, buddy. He's looking around, look.
Are you looking around?
Because Barbara declined interviews, we have an actor that will step in and answer some of the questions that Barbara may have answered if she were available. The acting is done by a new hire actor, and you will see his answers as best to our ability based off text messages received. Thank you for your understanding. Thank you, Barbara. Thank you, Barbara. Thank you, Barbara. Thank you, Barbara, for taking the time to talk to me.
Uh-oh. Can you not be serious right now?
I'm just gonna hold up the question. I'm just gonna hold up the question.
Man, I wanna get out of this damn dress.
Okay. I'm so sorry. Okay, okay, seriously, we gotta get this done, okay?
Okay.
Thank you, Barbara, for taking the time to talk to me. When you first saw the kitty, what did you think?
Stop laughing. You can't be doing it like this, man.
Barbara, when you first saw the kitty, what did you think?
Okay. Stop. Let's get this over with.
Question.
I'm trying to, okay. Well, it was a quite good kitty. So tiny kitty. Such a tiny little kitty.
Oh, here we go.
Hi, y'all.
Hey.
All right, guys. Oh, Tipper's asleep out there. I think shut all the doors. I think I did.
Hey, is this okay? How you feeling?
I've been calling him, her, little one.
Come here, little one.
Because he's so small.
Oh, you scared? Did that scare you?
How sweet.
You smelling everything? You smelling everything?
Woo! I'm bouncing sideways.
So super playful.
Oh, that scared him. Hey, it's a carpet in the kitchen.
Do you remember that?
Mm-hmm.
Hey,
he's not 2 years. There's too much stuff going on.
Yeah.
But I could see him really liking that though.
Mm-hmm. And that's just a cat. They're gonna box. They're gonna box. He's quick.
Is that boxing? Yeah. Be careful now.
He's fine.
You be careful.
He's fine.
Just gonna hang out. I'm just gonna hang out. Hi. Hi, little kitty. We're gonna be best friends. Yeah. You're gonna like it here. It's a
fun house.
It's a
fun house.
I'll
send that too.
Cause this is perfect. This is an answer here. Thank you.
Sure.
Just said, let me.
Yep, I'm gonna cry now.
Thank you. Try to sit my, put my nipples in there. You guys are great. Thank you for what you do.
Do you have Molly hung over here? Where's Molly?
I don't have any pictures of anything on the wall yet because, seriously, we just finished the renovation like
last month.
Okay. I mean,
I'll dig back because there's gonna be that.
I can send you a picture.
Yeah, that, and do you remember, did you save the video of her on the couch with me?
Yes.
Please send that right. So I have it deep in my files, but I have to search for it. So do you have it?
Mm-hmm.
Send that. I want to put it in here because when I pull up, that's who I see.
Mm-hmm. She was such a sweetheart.
Hey, you want to give me kisses? Do you? Wait, where are you going? Where are you going? Hey, come here. Come here. Oh, what are you doing? What are you doing? Oh, hi, baby. Hi. Oh.
The fishing
call's
making up.
Tell mommy hi.
Tried.
Hey baby. I hope this is okay on the couch.
Oh yeah, it doesn't get any better than this.
Fine. Yeah, you sprawled out. Yes, you are. Yes, you are.
No, don't growl. So when she does the whole it freaks me out. I don't know if she's gonna bite me or what, man. I'm asking the parents now. Like, it's, what the heck? So she's had trauma, like, and can be aggressive. So you could see, like, she was so happy and then was like, boom, could bite me up. And, like, you saw that, right? It was so scary for a minute there. It could have been my face. So mom was like, she could bite you. Note taken.
And just because it's like bipolar, it's like she's all in my lap loving me, and then she's like, you know, it's scary. So this is why I was like, wow, it's perfect that I caught it on camera, because that's realistic in my world, right? But it could be very dangerous. So like, as your groomer, as your pet sitter, as somebody on the outside, I can tell you, you never know what your dog can do. This is a dog that knows me, and whoa. Like, she's happy, right? But she can instantly change on me, so I have to be very careful. The tail wagging doesn't mean happiness, it means touch. Like, tail wagging is touch, not happiness necessarily, touch of any kind. I'm gonna bite you, I want you to touch me, I wanna touch you, you know. Mom's like, don't let her on the couch, and now she's like, I want on the couch. Oh, good. Okay, great. All right, Molly, good girl. Did your mommy just give you a little talking, Molly? Did your mommy just talk to you?
The master, I'm just gonna put him down here.
The master of... Sometimes meanness, but
you just shut this before we get out of hand here.
Where you been? I've been mean. Where you been? I've been hungry. Hungry. Come here. Here we are.
Okay.
I don't know how you want to do it.
We did. So we might change this. I feel like this could be dangerous later, but a table really helps us. How we did it last time was good. Feet up to me.
Okay.
The bottom of the feet up to me so I can see the nails.
Mm-hmm.
But I just don't want someone to get hurt in the long run. So
how's that going?
So
he's
just,
pretty good.
Oh, you're good. You're good.
Okay.
So I'm going to push you back there. Okay. There you go. Is he good there? Okay.
Mm-hmm. You're good. You're a good boy. Be a good boy. Shh. Hey. There you go. You're mouthy.
I've never seen the kitten act like this ever. Why? What happened?
Okay. What we have these gloves for?
Really? Really?
Yeah.
Are you faking it? Stop. You're good. You're good. We've been doing this how long?
How beautiful are those little pink pads? See, that feels better.
These are pretty short. Okay. Watch the head for me here. So this hand. Yep. There you go.
Here, let me do
it. Yep. Because I'm going to pull this arm here.
You're okay. I know. But we're gonna be doing this.
Wow, yourself.
He's okay.
Did he get through that glove?
Not yet. Not
just,
yet.
You're good there.
He's just
there.
Pissed, that's all.
Mm-hmm. Oh, there's a couple sharp ones there. How did that happen? No, don't do that. Don't kick off me.
I'm fine. I got you.
Hang in there.
Good. Well.
Okay.
Take it in.
You're
like
okay.
It. You
You're
get
okay.
What you get, you don't throw a fit. That's all there is to it. Look at his
Let
little...
Let me double check stuff here.
Look at his little whiskers growing in.
I know, they were short before too. I was watching, they're so cute.
They're coming.
Really want to get them as short as I can, but we're right there anyway.
Willen is, he settles down. I mean, he gets that tail swishing, but he's got attitude. Deluxe. You're okay. Get used to it, because this is how we're doing it. As long as Dee Dee's comfortable.
Right. Mm-hmm. That's a good one. Remember this. This is fine. This is fine. I like that. Put right there. You might do that at
and
home.
I've got him
you
up
might
underneath.
Do this at home and let people touch him so that he can just stop fighting it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the biting and all that. Maybe he'll do it once a day at home. And maybe he'll get, because he calmed down. See?
Yeah. He's teething too. I don't know if you can see his little bitty teeth underneath. They're like baby sharp.
Because he's a boss, you know.
Oh, he is. He's... He's
so now, look, he calmed down.
Mm-hmm.
Nothing happened.
See,
no pain.
I've got him right up underneath his armpits.
Yeah, this is nice. I like this.
And he's good.
This is good stuff. And if you do this and treat and feed him, check this out. You might change the dynamic of how he behaves for feed.
You see how you're gently biting me there? Let's not do that, okay? Look, today your mama's moving in here. She's gonna get her stuff. Okay?
Barbara, when the kitten bit you the first night you had him, how did you feel?
Well, he's a kitten, you know, so I was in it for the long haul, and I thought it was pretty normal for a kitty to do that. I mean, all kitties do that, don't they? Am I doing pretty good? It's just the outfit.
I think you got some cleavage.
Oh my god.
UPS showed up!
Let's have a grin. Let's have a. I can hear your motor running.
Within 24 hours of the kitten being in her home, the kitten bit her. I offered to have the kitten brought back right away. She insisted it was okay, and that was just probably something surface level. How can a kitten become so mean so fast? The kitten was never aggressive with me. I don't know what happened.
Barbara, how did you feel when you finally had to make the call to give the kitten back for your safety?
Well, it was very terrifying. I just didn't know what to do. It was a tough situation. I'm sorry.
Now that the kitten is back, for the safety of all staff, the kitten does go through a waiting period. This same kitten was also the same kitten that had bitten Barbara over 3 times, crawled and jumped on her body and scaled her clothing multiple times, bit and swiped and scratched and tore up her husband, and even did some really interesting things like urinating on the bed of her daughter, who was really gonna be the number one owner for the kitten. She really needed the love.
you feel like Dee Dee really loves you?
I do. I feel like Dee Dee really loves me. She took care of me the whole time. Well, she gave me a free cat. Can you guys believe that she prepared this cat for me since I lost my kitty and lost Molly? She loves me so much.
Thank you so much for watching this season 2, episode 1. We're not completely done with the story of the kitten that came into our lives. If you happen to have an interest in him, please contact me. You never know when you're going to rescue a dog, a cat, a horse, or any other species. You never know when they're going to come into your life. I hope when that moment faces you, you are able to help the animal if you can. Life can't be perfect for that animal, for you, for me, but sometimes we have an opportunity face us, and I always talk about it. You can take the opportunity or you can pass the opportunity. Sometimes you're not able to, and I get it, but sometimes you just have to. And in this case with this kitty, I did. I got him right into my car, and my goal was to save his life and find him a great home. This kitty has been attached to my hip. He's super playful. He is still a kitten in his mind. He's less than 1 year old. And if you have a story like this, please share and comment down below what you've been through with those that you've rescued. I have a handful of rescues under my belt, and I've helped a many. All we can do is try, and all we can do is our best, especially when it comes to animals that cannot fend for themselves or speak for themselves. Anytime you are rescuing, helping in a tragic scenario, it doesn't always look pretty. Have you ever worked at a veterinarian office? I can guarantee you some things that you need to see, some things you've never seen, they don't look pretty when you're trying to help an animal survive. And no matter what it looks like, just know I've got your back. If your main goal is the animal, we can usually all see it, can't we? Thanks again for watching. I hope to see you on season 2, episode 2.